filming this on my birthday. And for my birthday, I'm like, oh, I'm gonna do something crazy with my hair. Except I'm telling people that I dyed it. But it's obviously actually because I'm a mermaid, but you know, we can't tell people the truth, right guys? So these are basically going to be like hacks that are going to help in more serious situations, although it is very helpful that you can use a spoon for contour. Fun hack in there for you. I'm giving away 2 record players and all you have to do is be subscribed to this channel and you're automatically entered. And I'm also going to give away 5 Polaroids. Yes, you guys are going to make me broke. And all you have to do is follow on Instagram, Twitter, and you're automatically entered. And yes, I can check. Comment what hair I should do next. And if this gets to 20,000 likes, I promise you, I will do that hair color. And I actually chose this color because a lot of you guys said an aqua would look good. So I was like, my subscribers know best. They're all cooler than me. And if you're not subscribed, be sure to subscribe. I will link it right here. And without further ado, let's get started. So it can be really hard in your life to know someone that is super sick. My mom recently had cancer twice. That's actually a funny story why I got my hair pink in the first place. Though some people said it was to be punk rock. I wish I was punk rock, please. One of the best things you can do is talk to someone. So there are online chat rooms for literally anything. And no, I'm not talking about the really inappropriate ones, guys. No, this is not a Tinder ad. See, I think I'm hilarious, but no one else does. Now, I know what it's like to just kind of smile and pretend everything's fine, and that really sucks. Cancer.net is a really good website for going to deal with parents that have cancer, how to deal with parenting if you have cancer, etc., etc. There's a website called Charity Navigator, and it'll literally just find the charity, and it's just kind of like reassuring to know that even if you're not directly helping your family, you're helping maybe one less kid not have to feel the way that you're feeling. And even if it comes from a mermaid with blue hair or like Mickey Mouse, it just feels good to hear, like it's going to be okay. And I just want you to know that whatever you're going through in life, stress is so real for teenagers. Teenagers are expected to get really good grades, decide what they're going to do with the rest of their lives, have a social life, do homework, lots of homework. And now we're stressed out. Okay, sorry. Perfectionist about school. Like, I put so much pressure on myself every single day. I get to the point where I feel like I'm just kind of like trudging through life. Happens to me a lot of the times. What I'll do is I'll have a day where I'll just have nostalgic old food. It's seriously the best, and it kind of like brings you back to like some of your just happier times. And good music, I go on 8-Tracks, literally search in any mood, fandom, yes. And I will go and search up the stress playlists, literally can change everything. Also, laughing is like the best medicine ever. I'm not funny, so I don't recommend watching me, seriously. If anything, you could laugh at how bad my jokes are, but I watch other YouTubers that I think are hilarious, and it makes me literally feel 10 times better. Little designated corner in my room that I will go to whenever I'm like super stressed out, and I put in there like a list of my favorite YouTubers, some of my favorite old books, and some nostalgic old food. Teenagers go through so much, and most of it is in their heads, caring about what people think. I know, because I used to be the shyest kid in my school, literally just because I was so scared about what people would think. But the thing is, people are so good at hiding these things. Every last word that you say to that person, you start judging and kind of like isolating. This will just help out with any situation in case anything happens, but I took a picture of all of the hotlines for eating disorders, depression, etc. I just have a picture of them on my phone so that in case anything happens, in case I feel horrible, a friend really needs that help that maybe I can't give. Really reassuring to have it. I really recommend that you do it. A lot of the times I like to pretend that it doesn't affect me, but it does. They're literally just words on a screen, and you're a person with awesome, unique thoughts. I just want to say this, you don't need to have any labels on you besides your own name. They're 1,000 times more valuable than pixelated words on a screen, which I personally have to remind myself sometimes when I read amazing books like The Fault in Our Stars. Sorry, I just got the feels there. I like to think about it like, you know, what would the 3-year-old version of you think if she saw you not eating ice cream with your friends because you didn't like the way you looked? You can report them. So I'm going to put right here all of the ways that you can report people on Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube, I guess. the most helpful life hacks I've ever given. As much as I love to make acai bowls and look up fandom playlists, that literally was my life in a sentence, wow. You think I'm kidding, but I'm not. No, really, I made two acai bowls today, and I was listening to a really, really, really good, it was like a Melanie Martinez aesthetic playlist. Also, I vlogged me getting my hair done, and I'm going to put it up hopefully the same time that I upload this video. So that was my day. How was your day? Just let me know, because you guys are all interesting. Just thank you so much. I'm just this really shy girl that goes to way too many concerts from New Jersey, so.